here in Cleveland, Ohio. We're making the first of two brewery stops. I was going to do Great Lakes Brewing Company first, but they're closed on Monday and Tuesday. So many breweries are just closed on random days. So we're going to Saucy Brewing Company, really close to the banks of Lake Erie. I can see the water straight ahead. So you can... Oop, there it is. But according to Cleveland.com, this is the best brewery in the city, in the whole metro area. We'll see. And we're going to see if they... what the food's like too. But anyways, see you inside. Okay, after waiting 20 minutes to get the food, or to get the beer, food came first. I'll go off on this afterwards. But they bring it in like a, or you pick it up from them in like this muffin tray. And the problem is there's no menus. All I have is this sheet. So I don't remember what kind each beer is. It doesn't say the ABV. So the first one I have is an Uber ASAP. Right here. It has like almost a creamsicle. Orange meets vanilla. A juicy IPA with vanilla in it. It's an enjoyable beer. Flavors aren't crazy, but like after you get the citrus and the vanilla, there's not a whole lot else going on, but it's not bad. Drip is for like a drip, coffee pour. Bit of a maltiness on the tip of your tongue. Yeah, I wish I had the menu because it felt like they really churched up the description. It's fine, but I felt the description made it like sound like mind-blowing. It's kind of your basic stout. Alright, number three is the BF Heifer. The napkins is that school grade brown paper towel, you know, the stuff that never actually, you spilt milk, you didn't pick anything up, just kind of smeared it around the lunch table. It's the kind of napkins you get. Tastes like there's an IPA influence to it. There's a bit of a bitterness to it. There's a bit of a funk smell to it. It's almost like funk lager meets light IPA meets Hefeweizen. And for me, if I want my wheat beers to just be crisp, clean. cream, easy to drink, super refreshing. Me, that's just me personally. Like, I can get bitterness in most other beers. I want my half to just be really bitterness free almost. So this is like, if you like your wheat beers with a little extra IPA influence, you're gonna like this. It's not doing it for me. This next one is called Stealing Signs. I think there's a, like an American pale ale. I just got a beer. I like the name. Good baseball name. Yeah, this has got that classic pale ale taste to it. Got kind of like a autumn foliage maltiness. That makes sense. It's more in the middle of the tree. Because it has almost more of a Martin kind of malt to it. Not super heavy, but middle of the tongue. Use some honey. I like this one. Alright, last one is Fox Phobia, F-A-U-X-B-I-A, if the receipt's right. That's right. It's a white stout. I forgot I ordered that. Like, oh, this is interesting. You have vanilla coffee taste to it. Like, not super malty. But, like, you, if somebody handed this to you and you didn't know what it was, like me, I forgot. It's kind of like, this does not compute. This looks like a Pilsner, maybe? Chintzy Lager? White Stout. Oatmeal and some lactose going in there. I dig this. I like the it just like it doesn't make sense. Alright, my 5 samples out of the muffin top tray. Let's rate these. I don't know if I'll get another 5 because I don't feel like waiting 25 minutes. I gotta get into this later. Oh yeah, I'm gonna say 5 least favorite. Head advisor. I love a good wheat beer, but there's too many different styles going on for me. The worst wheat beer I've had before, but 5. 4, I'm gonna say it's drip, drip, drip. It's your standard stout, but they just churched it up too much in the description. They oversold it. 3rd, I'm gonna say is the Uber ASAP. Like a orange creamsicle IPA. 2, Stealing Signs. I think this is a nicely done American pale ale. Last, this this? Foxphobia. It just, it's unusual. It doesn't really make sense. It tastes good. It's just like, I don't know. I dig it. So, and while you're watching, if you haven't checked out the pretzel review, coming. Here they are. These are the pretzels. And I got a spicy chicken pizza. It's got the spicy chicken and the pickles on it and all that stuff. But check out the pizza review. I mean the pretzel review. I'll talk to you more in a second. And so it's like, okay, you know, it comes highly rated. And of course, you still have some COVID restrictions for restaurants and stuff. But it is, what is today? Today is June 22nd. So, the majority of COVID restrictions in the state of Ohio are gone. That said, this place was the biggest fucking pain in the ass to order anything of any restaurant, any brewery I've been to the entire pandemic. Giant pain in the ass. So you get there, you sit down. They have like that QR code thing that you try to scan with your phone. Doesn't work. This is really the first one I've had that hasn't worked. Which is like, okay, I'm not blaming my phone. Every other one has worked except yours. This is on you guys. I think it's because they wanted you to download their app. So I have to download the app. And then you'd be like, yes, I'm dining in. You gotta fill out all this stuff. You have to put in your mailing address or your billing address. It's like, well, why? I'm not trying to sign up for anything. Like, why do I have to put in my mailing billing address to order a beer, man? So you gotta fill out everything like you're ordering something like as a new customer on Amazon. So you fill all that stuff out. And it's like, okay, it accepts you. It says they send you a $5 coupon for $5 off your order, but then they don't accept the $5 coupon. Maybe this works if you are a resident of Cleveland, but if you're driving through, it's a waste of goddamn time. And so anyways, I get that everything filled out. They don't really have a flight, but you can order samples. And which was like the thing that I showed you in the muffin tin. Which is kind of like lowbrow bullshit. Come on, man. Don't get this 30-cent tin thing. Get something that's beer-oriented. And so, I order the 5 samples. I order an appetizer pretzel and pizza. Appetizer and pizza come out at the exact same time. Do you guys not know what the definition of a fucking appetizer is? Don't bring it out the same time as the main course. Oh, but they didn't bring it out. They just called my name.
Christian orders up.
So I go out and pick up both of them. It's like, thanks, guys. Dumbasses. So I pick them up. Beer's not done. It's been 25 minutes. My 5 sample beers aren't poured yet. So I'm like, okay. So I walk into the brewery. Be like, yeah, can I get the 5 samples I ordered like a half hour ago? And like the bartender just looks annoyed at me. Like, yeah, I can do that for you. It's like, yeah, you better fucking do that for you. It's your goddamn job. This is your job. This is what you do. It's not, it wasn't busy. There was nobody else there. Just like, well, there was people there, but there was nobody else ordering food or getting drinks. So just like, it's 5 samples. I shouldn't have to wait a half an hour to get these things. And so, I mean, the beers were fine. Like, they were better than a good chunk of the breweries I've been to. But it was just a complete waste of time, man. Like, I just... And so, like, the only reason I went there was so I could write up that article. Like, okay, instead of, if you're in Chicago, in Cleveland, you're gonna you're probably going to go to Great Lakes Brewing Company, but instead go here. No, there is no way in good faith I can recommend them at all. Zero chance. I probably can't say any of this in the write-up, like I can't just trash a place. So I'm trashing it on here. Fuck you, Saucy. That was like, I've been on the road for 9 months. That was the most bullshit situation, period. And you can't blame pandemic stuff anymore. Like, you can't do that. Like, you've had a year and a half to figure that shit out, and it's just, I'm sorry. I'm just annoyed at the whole situation. It was just, like, really, Cleveland.com, you rated this the best one? I don't know, beers were fine, but, I don't know. If you're in Cleveland, fuck Saucy Brewing Company, fuck all of them, don't go there. Go anyplace else. Unless you just want to, like, waste your time. But anyways, the pretzels weren't that bad. They were decent. But again, you'll never have them because you'll never go there. If you're listening to my word. But anyways. I gotta go walk off the limp crust pizza that I ordered. So anyways, I'll catch you guys later. I'm going to the Great Lakes Brewing Company tomorrow because they're closed on Monday and Tuesday. I don't know what it is with these places closed on just random days, but I'm gonna go there tomorrow. So you'll probably see that video later. But anyways, guys, take it easy, and I'll see you guys later.